गुड इवनिंग ऑल ऑफ यू. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू क्लास 7 मैथमेटिक्स एक्सरसाइज 2.6, दैट इज पार्ट 10. सो दिस एक्सरसाइज इज बेस्ड ऑन डेसिमल मल्टीप्लिकेशन. नाउ फॉलो दिस क्वेश्चन नंबर 1. फाइंड द फॉलोइंग. सो 2.7 इंटू 4. सो दिस वन you can write 2.7 as 27 by 10 into 4. So you can write 27 into 4, you can write 108 divided by 10, that is equal to 10.8. no, because you have to shift, since you have denominator 10, so you have to shift the decimal one place before from the extreme right. So here I am going to start that exercise, but I'll show you direct method, that is the shortcut method, how to do. So this is part 10. Last class we have done part 8 and 9, part 9. So exercise 2.6, chapter 2, part 10. Find the product. Number 1, 2.7 by 4, 2.7 into 4. So you multiply directly, that is 4, 7, 28, write 8, carry 2, 4 to the 8 plus 2, 10. Now count decimal point from right side, decimal place, that is one number. So count one number from right side and put decimal. So your answer is 10.8. Then the this is not number 2. I have taken this one. 4.35. This is number 4, some number 4. So write some number 4 here. So I have taken one more sum of exercise 1. Simple multiplication you all know. So 4.35 into 2.3. So write one under the other. Now multiply, as you multiply ordinary numbers. So when you multiply 435 by 3, you get 1305. Next step, you multiply this by 2, you get 870. Now you add 5, 0, 7 plus 3, 10, 0, carry 1. Plus 8, 9, plus 1, 10. Now put decimal, count again from right side. Here upper number you have decimal after two places, one number you have decimal after one place. So total you have 2 plus 1. You have to put decimal therefore after three places. Okay, so count again from right side, 1, 2, 3, and put decimal. So your answer is 10.005. All right. So this way other sums also you can do. Now next I have taken sum number 2. Here all you have to divide. Number 2 you have to divide 10.8 by 4. So 10.8 you write, divided by 4. It's going by 2 times by 2, 4 to the 8. Subtract, you get 2, bring down 8. 28, 4 7 ja. So you get 2.7. Alright, that is your answer. And number 2, fourth one, is given 4.28 by 0.02. So here you have to both numerator, denominator, both decimal numbers. So both you have decimal before two places. So you shift the decimal, just remove decimal, that is why, because here also you have decimal before two places, here also decimal before two places. So just remove the decimal and write 428 by 2. Now divide directly. So 2 2s are 4, bring down 2 2 1s are 2, again 8 2 4s are 8, so your answer is 214. All right, go to sum number 5. Follow the question number 5 here. Find the area of a rectangle whose length is 5.7 centimeter and breadth is 3.5 centimeter. You will find out the area of rectangle. You know area of rectangle is equal to length into breadth. So write that area is equal to L into B. Right, is equal to 5.7 into 3.5. Now decimal point 5.7, you write then write 57 by 10. Okay. Because decimal you have up to one place. So divide that by 10, therefore 3.5 you can write 35 by 10. Multiply 57 into 35, 1995 by 100, 10 tenger. So now put decimal. Since denominator you have 20, so count from right side then and put decimal after two places. So decimal will come then before 9. So answer is coming 19.95 centimeter square. That is your answer. That is the area of rectangle. Alright, so this you also you can multiply, or you can multiply directly also as I showed you. Now next part 11, so that is sum number 8. Read the question again. If 1 kg of pure milk contains 0.245 kg of fat, how much fat is there in 12.8 kg of milk? So here you are given 1 kg of milk contains 0.245 kg fat. So to find out total amount of fat in 12.5 kg milk, you have to multiply 12.8 into 0.245. Alright, so write now this way. Now follow the question. 1 kg of pure milk contains 0.245 kg fat. Okay, can you see? So first step, you write this way. 1 kg of pure milk contains 0.245 kg fat. Therefore, 12.8 kg of milk contains 12.8 into 0.245. So you can write 12.8 as 128 by 10 into 0.245, you can write 245 by 1000. Now multiply the numerators, you get 31,360 divided by 1 and then 4 zeros. So now just skip the decimal from right side, extreme right, you have to put it after four numbers. So decimal will come before one. No, because here the last zero, you don't have right, it's useless. So right, therefore 3.136 kg. Okay. Now, one thing I'll tell you, all this now part you check, if you don't get any part, so you can inform me through Rajinder Miss. Okay, if I know, I'll continue again that part so that you all get all those parts serially. Then next is number 11. Sum number 11, again you check, see the sum is given. How many ice cream cones can be filled from 8.4 liters of ice cream if one cone can be filled with 35 milliliters of ice cream? So one cone contains therefore 35 milliliters of ice cream. Now here, do one thing, 8.4 liters that you change into milliliter, okay, and then you divide that by 35 milliliters to find out number of cones. Alright, now follow the question and solution. One cone can fill 35 milliliters of ice cream, right? That's first statement. Okay, one cone can fill 35 milliliters of ice cream. Now 8.4 liters is equal to how many milliliters that you find out? So it multiply by 1000 is equal to 84 by 10 into 1000, you get how much? 8400 milliliters. Okay, 0 1 0 1 0 cancelled, so you get 84 into 100, 8400 milliliter. So now to find out the total number of cones that can be filled, you have to divide 8400 by 35. Now divide here, I have showed 8400 divided by 35, so ultimately divided completely, so you get answer 240. So 240 cones you can fill with 8.4 liters of ice cream. All right go to the next number. Now if you have you copied this one, number 11, next number 13, that is the last sum. If 2/3 of a number is 10, then what is 1.75 times of that number? Simple sum. So write first, let the number be x. Why? Because it is given, if 2/3 of a number is 10, so 2/3 of x is equal to 10, you can write. So that therefore let the number be x, therefore 2/3 of x, that is into x, is equal to 10. Now simplify and find the value of x, therefore x is equal to 10 into 3 by 2. Reduce now, you get 5 to the 15. Alright. So this is the number. This is the number. So number you got is equal to 15. Now again next part given, then what is 1.75 times of that number? So 1.75 times means you have to multiply. So 1.75 into 15. So multiply directly, or you can multiply this also, 175 by 100. Because after decimal you have two numbers, two places. So put two zeros, denominator, into 15. 175 into 15 is equal to 2625 by 100. So again, when you are dividing by 100, two zeros, denominator. So you have to shift decimal two places before, from the right. So you get 26.25. That is your answer. All right.